Hey guys, welcome back to Kamicraft, and we are just coming back from J-Man's banner shop, because we're going to have J-Man make some banners for us. I'm getting tired of the banner we have now as the main banner I use on this map. So we're going to have him design a new one, and then we're also having him design a personal banner for the shop. Or not personal banner, but a banner just for the shop that makes it seem like it's more of an armory, because as of right now, it doesn't. One of the guys on the server, Bank, he went ahead and set up some more custom trades. So, you guys on the server, if you have eggs, come spend them. Let's check. Ooh, I already sold some boots. That. I need to refill this. This thing is, lacking. Sword's already gone. Dang. So, even though I just filled the shop, looks like I need a refill. But, yeah, guys, so we're getting ready to work on the storage system for our carrot and potato farm. We're also going to be doing on this episode. So, I'm going to get back to you when we get back to base. Alright, guys, so we're down here working on the silos. I've got them laid out. And I had a different plan. I was going to use the silos that kind of lit up, let you know exactly how much stuff you had in it. But we do not have the room back here, so we're going with this. So, 4 single chests. Not a lot of stuff, or not a lot of storage at all. Which is kind of a waste, I think. But then again, we're not making super efficient farms, remember? Do we want to do one more in the... No, we can't do one more. So, yeah, this is what we're going to go with. Bye, Bank. Hi, Bank. So, I think it's going to be like something like that. And then we'll come over here and we're going to do the hopper straight down. And all of this stuff, I'm going to sort below here. So what will happen is behind these we'll have enough room for a 3x3 going up. I think I've got enough room for a 3x3. Ooh, real close. So the 3x3 will go into a hopper like right here. I guess I could go up one more. If I really wanted to. If we wanted to do 5 chests. Which we might do because this one's half down. Let's go ahead and just put the 5th one in there. Knock this out. We'll knock this guy out. Which means we need to knock this guy out. And I can't pop up anymore. But I want that half slab. So we go like this. And then like this. Yeah, okay, that'll work. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead and finish setting all these guys up, and then I'm going to dig the lines for where we're going to have the sorter, because we're going to have the sorter below here. It's going to be really weird. Like, let's just go downstairs real quick, and I'll show you guys. So the item elevator for all our farms is going to be right here. It's going to be this little, like, 5 wide, including this. And it's going to go up here, and then the line's going to cut across and into this area, and this is where I'm going to hide the sorters for carrots, potatoes, and sugarcane. And then once they're sorted, they're going to be in item elevators that'll then shoot them up to us. So they'll come and they'll be in here. I guess I could figure out a way to put some kind of lights in here. But I'm not too worried about it. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So let me finish here, and then I'll dig out the room for the sorters, and we'll get the lines all worked out. Alright, guys, we're back. I am sorry for this, but this is going to be a huge jump cut, because my shadow play stopped working, and I finally got it back to where it can record some more. And bam! I know earlier we were talking about I was going to dig an area out down here, and then I was going to have item elevators that came up, And then I realized then I really it would be a lot of extra work to sort it. So what I did was I have one item elevator coming up. We've got a run that comes right through here underneath. That's going to go out to the sugarcane farms and all that stuff. We're going to work on the item elevator for that right now. This stuff is not actually hooked up. I've been manually kind of putting the sugarcane in there. We've got a lot of villagers. You can see I've been doing some trading. So we've got a couple, like, we've got good villagers. They're just expensive. So hopefully we can find some cheaper ones. We just got this guy. What is this guy? Toolsmith. So we want him. And yeah, we silk touch for 16. That's probably, that guy and this guy are probably the best guys I have right now. Just because these are, I mean, right here, if I can just get a halfway decent efficiency book, I mean, that's my axe is all done, or my pickaxe is pretty much done with just these two guys, which is really awesome. But yeah, I really ended up liking how I did this. I'm not sure if I showed this off, but this is the lighting I went for on this floor. And you can see right now we got Bank down here working. He's building me an elevator. He's got this cool custom elevator he uses. And he's going to build an elevator because things I forgot. Like in here, you look around, there's no crafting table in here. So I ended up making a little block swapper right here. I checked online. There were a lot of different ones out there, but there weren't any that fit in this hole. Let's kind of climb back here. Make it. Yeah, so this was a space I had, and there were a couple good designs out there, but none of them that did what I needed to do. And crap, I don't have any blocks or anything to get out of here. Let's steal some of these. But yeah, that's what we got so far. So what we're gonna be working on now, we're gonna go down to the sugarcane farm. We can actually fall. So yeah, sugarcane farm, you guys know right now, it just kind of goes off to the side and man, is it getting filled. I'm gonna have to build the on-off switch for this. Yeah, so that room Bank's working on, that's gonna be like extra storage and the on-off switches for all these farms. But right now, we need to switch the water because it's going to come up over here. You can see I started the ice path. I'm getting kind of low on packed ice. But yeah, so the ice path is going to come over here. I didn't continue it out all the way because I wasn't sure exactly where I wanted to do this. Because like I said, I want on-off switches for all these things. So, yes. I don't know if I just want the on-off switch to do an overflow or just let these things grow. Now for the carrots and potatoes we're going to have over here, I have to do the overflow on-off because I can't get the villagers just to stop. But with this guy, I can have this guy just turn off, and over here I'm going to probably do pumpkins and melons. So they're all going to be running off that timing circuit we had back there. So I'll just probably tell these guys to turn off and don't bother auto-harvesting. But yes, give me a couple minutes. I'm going to go check with Bank, see if he needs anything. And then I'll bring you guys back when we have a design for the elevator. Okay, so we're back, and it's been probably close to a week since that last clip you guys saw. You heard in the last clip, I've been having issues with Shadowplay. I had some issues with my microphone. Some people heard a humming noise, other people didn't. I think I've got that finally fixed. So I wanted to not record anything till I had time to sit down and actually do it. And I think I got it fixed. But like I said, here's the design for the item elevator. I went ahead and switched the sugarcane farm so the water streams are now going in the proper direction, whereas last time they were going over there. And look, here they go. We can actually watch it now. So the items will come through here. And then they go. I've got this on a slow tick because I didn't like all the items clumping all the way up. But yeah, so it's just a gradient of blue glass, light blue glass, light gray, and then white. And then at the top, I've got this water stream that just pushes everything that way. And then to our item elevator going up into our sorting system, and I've fallen in water. Matter of fact, let's go up there and check this out. So yeah, all the sugarcane should be coming up through here. It may have already passed through. It'll come down here, and you know what? You guys saw Bank was working on this last time in that clip. I've done a little bit of touch-up stuff just to kind of clean it up. I figured a nice window wall would be nice right here. This is where we're going to have our control panel to the farms, and this is where the item elevator stuff comes through here. I also have a little thing. So when we kill our villagers, sometimes they get stuck on this rail right here. And this allows me to be like, okay, everything's clear. I can kill another villager. Because when they get backed up, like, this thing is a pain. So, you know what? I don't know why I have water there. I probably could have just done a two drop all the way down. Either way. But, yeah, so here we go. This is the what's going to be the storage room. I've just kind of got some trading supplies, some repairing supplies, and everything like that. So I'll have storage on this wall, and I think I will go with shulker boxes. I think I'll dye them to look good, and we'll have like an entire wall full of shulker boxes. And then here will be the control panel. So we'll have a switch to the timer that's doing the sugarcane. I didn't want to do the actual destroy the items from the sugarcane drop. So we're just going to turn the timer off and just let the sugarcane grow 3 high. Since we have the design that can break 3 high, we're good with that. Next, we're going to be working on the carrot and potato farm. And that's going to be rather fun. I was going to use a tutorial that I found online. The one that everyone uses. I think it's Unary Bits again. But I'm not sure if I really want something that powerful, because that thing produces carrots and potatoes like it's nothing, and I don't think I need anything that big. So, yeah, I'm going to keep looking, and I'll see if I can't maybe even just tweak that design to fit what I want. But, yeah, so that's next. I really should go ahead and start working on this, but I can't until I get carrots and potatoes in. So I think I'm going to figure out the carrot and potato situation and bring you guys back for that. Alright guys, we are back and I've got our farming cells all done. Hey, Box Kitties is on. Let's say hi. Okay, so here's where our farms are going to be. Now, all I've done is really dig out a big area and build the shell. I didn't want to put that on camera because let's face it, that's nothing special. So, the big issue we're going to have is our villagers are going to go in here. And I think I've already messed up with how close this wall is. I think I'm going to have to push it back some. But what we're going to do is we're going to have a villager on this side. I might do it over against this one. So that our villager in here, the farmer, farms and he comes over here, he goes to throw the crops. And he'll throw it down this one. And then on this side, we'll have the villager up here. And that means I can have the hoppers kind of separated. So at the same time, I can do my on-off switches or my overflow switches. So if I have too much carrots and potatoes, I could say, yo, just get rid of this. Don't let them circulate through my base. I don't want to create that kind of lag on the server. So, what I've got to do now is set up a rig to catch some villagers. Now, I do have, if you guys remember the piston little thing we've set up, here we go, for the villagers to say, hey, I've got all the villagers I need. I don't need any more. I think it's right here. I think it's right here. So these guys will drop down and splat right here and die. So then I put a water drop like right here and catch these villagers and maneuver them into place this way. Especially now that I know I just need to be right here. So that's going to be easy enough. I'm trying to think. Carrots and potatoes, I can get a massive amount of that from Spawn Town. The hardest part is make sure I get farming villagers. I need some brown coats. So that's probably going to be me sitting there watching the drop. hoping to get a farmer. And hey, is a farmer, save him. If it's not a farmer, maybe put him in these little slots. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get ready. I'm going to do one of these. I don't know if I'll have a villager in place. But I will do one and bring you guys back to show you how it's going to work. Okay guys, we are back and the very first villager we got was a farmer. Which, hopefully we can get that lucky again on the upstairs. The next guy was this toolsmith. So we'll be good with him there. I went ahead and got a little bit of this done. So you, I didn't show really, you'll see right here, I'm hoping this guy will do all of his carrots and potatoes, walk over here, look up and try to throw it up to him, and it'll get caught in this water stream and then head to the back right there. Now this is where it gets cool. I thought I was going to have to hook up like a dropper to throw it in lava and everything, but the way I was able to do it was everything will come down this chute, I'll land right there, and then I've got these guys' pistons hooked up that will interchange. So right now it's I want to keep everything, and say from up there I turn the switch off, so it powers everything. You see this piston pushes out, which stops the water from flowing. Now I've got it all lit over there, so nothing spawns on that ice path. And then the items will fall straight through this water block, because items always go to the bottom, and then land in that pool of lava down there. So that saves a little bit of redstone. Now I've got to do that again with the potatoes, and I'm not 100% sure, because I didn't realize how much space I took up until I just looked at it right now. I mean, the easiest thing is to turn carrots and potatoes off at the same time, but I don't want to do that. I might try to just, well, I should have enough space to recreate it on this side too. My only thing is, if my carrots are off and my potatoes are on, I don't want the potatoes to run through this onto this line, even though it's a dead straight. So I might have the potatoes circle back around and go underneath this farm before lining up, because this ended up being a straight shot to the hopper for the item elevator. And let's go back up here, because I want to show you, I was off when I said, hey, this was our, there we go, saved by middle click. When I said this was the drop chute, it really wasn't. There was another, let's see this, I've been trying to prep for the next guy. The drop chute's actually like right here. And so what I've been doing is you do this, and then like I'll close this area off with glass or something like that, and weasel him onto a minecart, and I pushed him into place, broke said minecart, and we've all been good. So I've been just kind of letting them drop right now. If I'm not ready for them, I just let them drop. So that's how this is set up. I need to get another one up here, and I need to get another farmer. While I'm waiting on those guys to drop, I'm going to go ahead and do the other version of this onto this side and get that set up, and I'll bring you guys back when hopefully we're going to be planting crops. Alright guys, status update. This bottom one should technically be done. I just planted the carrots down. He has been farming carrots, so hopefully we're all good there. I've yet to see him throw any at that guy, but you can see like most of the carrots aren't grown up yet. I've heard him break a couple and replant. I am still waiting on a farmer for up here. This is, I don't know, it's 3 or 4 hours after the last clip. I just tilled this so I'm able to see how much, make sure all the ground and water reaches all the way around. I've had to add a couple little spots in the wall, and that's fixed a lot of the dry issues. Oh, and I did want to show this really cool thing. You see the magma block behind here? Like, this needs to be light level 8, and it was 9 when I had a sea lantern up there. So what I did is I took the magma block, and I can move the sea lantern around near the magma block to adjust the light right here. And I thought that was really cool, even though I've got like a torch sitting right there. You're not going to be able to see that from out there, so I'm not worried about it. But right, I think it's right here, I've got the track set up, so we can literally just kind of plop a villager in here. Oh man, I might need to make some more little water pathways over here. Doesn't look like we're getting enough moisture. So yeah, I think I'm going to run back to town. I went in town, grabbed carrots, came back and planted them. I might run back to town, grab potatoes, and go ahead and start planting so they're all fully grown by the time that guy gets there. Okay guys, I am back after AFKing overnight, and that's not good. I would have expected more. Let's go down there and take a look. Yeah, see, like, their entire crops are... Okay, guys, we are back, and I figured this out. So, the little pressure plate mechanism you see over there that's supposed to pop the crop right underneath the villager, even though the light level was correct, according to the tutorial, it didn't want to do it. So I had to lower the light level again, which is why you see the one end rod up there instead of the sea lanterns, because an end rod is one light level lower than the sea lanterns, and that's just enough to pop the crop right there. So I had to do it on the potato farm up there and the carrot farm down here, and now these things work perfectly. You could hear it just constantly going, potatoes, carrots, we got some sugar cane flowing in there. This thing is working excellent now. So we have no problems there. So if you guys experienced the same issue, that's what it was. For some reason that crop wasn't popping. You see this guy, he keeps running in there to go replant that one crop, and he ends up throwing all of his carrots and stuff in there, except for this time. He must not have a lot. But yeah, so I've also went ahead, you can see the line of slabs running through right here. That is, let's come up here, come out. I went ahead and got the sugarcane on-off line in, and that's what it is. It's running through there. The carrots and potatoes, I believe I'm going to put on this side, and they're going to go right in between the drop for the spawner drop farm and the item, or not item elevator, the minecart elevator. So we should be good there. Okay, so I've now got, I believe, is the carrot line in, and I've showed you guys what it looks like when they come. Well, I'll show you in a second, but you can see I'm doing the torch drop I did for the squid farm. So this just is a torch tower down, and then it comes around like this, and then it hooks up to this little gadget right here. Alright guys, so all three redstone lines are in. You can kind of see them hanging up over there. Looks like we got some potatoes going through. Awesome. Yeah, I really like how they're kind of on half slabs and they're hanging out like this. It makes... So upstairs we have a lot of kind of medieval looking stuff and trying to hide some redstone. But when we did the villager area, nah, we kind of just left it exposed. And I think it really does look awesome. I think we got some carrots coming. Still potatoes. Anyways, so let's go up. I'm going to take that away at some point. Let's go up and I'll show you the control room, because the control room is now finished. So if we come this way, go down the elevator, here's the control room. It is all finished. All these guys are wired in. I went ahead and put a light on there. And this guy is left for expansion, which we're already know what's going to go there. It's going to be pumpkins. I locked the farming villager the other time. I thought I could get away with just doing carrots and potatoes. I was wrong. I had to go to Bank's place and borrow some pumpkins to unlock him. So we'll be doing a pumpkin farm sometime. Not next episode. I already have an idea for next episode, and it's going to be a less technical episode, way more building. But that's this area down here. We've got our storage. This is whenever I'm trading with an armor smith or a weapon smith. This is the librarian box, and this is just kind of random stuff that I need. Got down here, we've got the killing chamber for the villagers still. Overall, I really like this room. It looks really nice. So, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, hit a like. Please don't forget to subscribe. I think I've got a fancy new icon in the bottom right-hand corner, so you could click subscribe anytime during the episode. Yeah. Like always, guys, have a good one. Hope to see you again. See ya.